Olga, I've received a confirmation that the American is a subversive, a hysteric by nature, and has gotten it into her head to accompany an old lunatic to some imaginary island. On the way, she has caused a great deal of nuisance for the authorities, and above all, has associated herself with those freeloading yokels. Damn her! It also seemed that Uncle Sam considers her to be of some importance. This is a good occasion to get rid of her. When I get to Valsambor, my men will arrest her and deliver her to her country's authorities. Until then, take good care of her. So, at least they don't want me dead, eh? So that's the colonel, the guy we just saw. Regarding Zamyatin. Colonel, I've received a report of the commission concerning the clinic management, and with all due respect to our comrade commissars, I believe that putting Zamyatin to one side on my behalf would be an error. He almost never leaves the office anymore, of course, and he delegates all responsibility to me. But his signature is the one appearing at the bottom of every document, even the ones concerning my experiments. I therefore feel that it would be better to let him remain behind his desk. He makes the perfect straw man. Indeed, and if anything would ever go wrong, he would get the blame and not her. That's the whole point of it. Arriving soon, Dr. Efimova. My name is Nick Cantin. Oh, that's the detective from the second game. And without bragging, I'm acknowledged as the best private detective on the east coast of the USA. Well, they do say that in the second game as well. I'm contacting you following a telephone conversation you had with my client, the law firm Marston & Lawmond. As agreed, I'll be arriving in the next few days to honor the terms of the contract you agreed to with the firm concerning the extradition of Kate Walker. One point still bothers me, though. Is it true that Miss Walker had to be arrested by some sort of local militia? During the day, I'd like to have a video conference with you to clarify this point and go over the last few practical details concerning my arrival. His signature, the finest private investigator on the East Coast. Good for you. Psychiatric. In the boiler room? Really? That's from Dr. Mangolin. Not to be confused with Mengele. In accordance with your recommendations, I subjected patient number 10, the American Kate Walker, to the standard psychiatric interview. Even though at first glance she seems convincing, the patient nonetheless demonstrated all the symptoms typical of the propensity for anarchy so common in her misguided homeland. Worse, it turns out she subscribes completely to the cause of the Yukol nomads, and it is obvious that she intends to continue agitating in our beloved region. I therefore recommend an emergency protocol restricting her movements and interaction with other patients who might be encouraged to agitate for the young nomad. I will have the mechanical bed calibrated for the patient with this in mind in preparation for your response. Okay, that's all very lovely.
Hello, Miss Efimova. I'm here to see you two.
Is that Canton?
Walker, it really is you. What a coincidence. I've been looking for you for weeks.
Mr. Cantin, I presume?
Ah, I see that my reputation precedes me. Miss Efimova must have told you I was coming.
No, I just now learned of your existence, Mr. Cantin. A while ago, my employer in New York informed me that he was going to stick a detective on my back.
I don't like to boast, but I'm the best detective on the East Coast. Never a problem with me. I've been asked to bring you back home safe and sound, Miss Walker. I should be in Valsambor in a few hours.
I need an answer, Miss Walker.
Yes, yes.
I have no need of a knight in shining armor holding my hand, Mr. Cantin.
Look, Miss Walker, I'm just doing my job.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid you've made the trip for nothing.
Yes. I mean, I'm not so sure. The Justice Department is looking for you, you know.
Really?
The feds are looking for me? But what's the charge? I've done nothing wrong.
Embezzlement! A Apparently you took off with a contract for the sale of the clockwork toy factory in Vorarlberg. And you took advantage of the seller's senility. You're even suspected of being responsible for the death of one of them. A Mr. Hans Vorarlberg, the last heir authorized to sign contracts with the company you represented. That's not negligible. You know, Miss Walker.
This is completely ridiculous. And as far as I know, you aren't authorized to represent the Justice Department in this country. You're just a detective. So you'll have to put up with it, Mr. Cantin. I'm not going back to New York with you. So leave me alone.
Wait, Miss Walker. Please be reasonable.
Goodbye, Mr. Cantin.
Oh, dear. Well, seems we did take off with that contract in the first game after all. And never did put it. Could have put it on the plane. Then again, there was no one to actually deliver it, so that would have gone badly. Okay. Ooh. Oh, okay. I'll need to find a clue somewhere. Okay. Red, red, green, blue, blue. Red, red, green. Oh, oh, stop. Blue. Mausoleum.
Charming.
Yes.
Oh. Hurry up.
Yes, Dr. Eltimova. I'm doing whatever I can. Get this damn tap open in the end, you'll see. Ah. Ah. That's it.
Well, that should convince the Yukel scum to strike camp and go back where she came from. Come on, Helmet. Let's not hang about here.
Yes, of course, Dr. Etimova.
Toxic waste. Polluting their water supply. That's evil. She's more evil than we thought, not less. Right, let's see if we can do anything about that. Thank you. gas can. That's something already. What's this? Nothing. Seems that they went for a more political storyline than in the previous games. More like, oh, what are they called? Amazon. And that other game that I can't remember the title, with the Black Panther.
Hydrochloric acid. Too dangerous without some kind of receptacle underneath.
Okay.
This thing is stuck.
That reminds me so much of the previous games where she said that in the exact same way. This thing is stuck. No point in trying that.
You've got to be kidding. I have to get rid of this chain. Fast.
Acid? I have no idea, to be honest, what hydrochloric acid does. But it's acid. If I was her, I'd just lie down in the boat instead of sitting upright. But if you can survive a coffin ride down a mountain, I'm sure you can survive a boat ride down a waterfall.